Hello， 大家好，我是秋迪。喜欢篮球的朋友，欢迎留言和订阅，多谢大家支持。昨天一年一度的麦当劳全美高中篮球邀请赛落下了帷幕。去年的这个时候，秋迪做了一期关于麦当劳扣篮大赛的视频，获得了不错的反响。今年的扣篮比赛可以说是更加的精彩，因为最终的冠军被一位女子选手夺得。更令人惊讶的是，本次参加比赛的男子选手实力可以说是十分强劲。全美排名第12的 Scotty Lewis 早就是这届高中生篮坛名声在外的扣将，而全美排名第2的 Cole Anthony 不仅拿过之前邀请赛的扣篮冠军，还曾经在训练后完成了这次准罚就线的起跳扣篮。面对这样实力不足的选手，这位高中女扣将的夺冠就更加显得含金量十足。这位名叫 Fran Belibi 的女子选手身高仅为6尺1寸，大约1米85左右，垂直弹跳高度可以达到80厘米。他上高中前从未打过篮球，是因为他们的高中篮球教练听说他可以扣进排球，才把他特招入队。他高一的时候是学校女子2队的替补队员，但由于他初中的爆发力和偏身体对抗的打法，他用了不到2年的时间就入选了美国国家少年队，并在高四成为了球队核心。他场均可以拿下21.8分和12.3个篮板，以及2.74盖帽，被 ESPN 排在全美高中生的第23位，并最终接受了来自斯坦福大学的篮球奖学金。废话不多说，秋迪整理了一下本次麦当劳邀请赛的所有球员的扣篮，大家一起来欣赏一下这位女扣将的夺冠历程。
My favorite part of dunking is how hype everyone gets after it. Everyone's excited. Like, my teammates are excited, fans are excited, coaches are excited. I guess it just makes me feel like really powerful. Like, I can do anything just because dunking is hard and it's like hard to get up there. And so, like, when you get up there and you just throw the ball down, it's really empowering. I'm just hoping that.Girls can see like that we can do anything, no matter what people tell us. We can do anything we want to do if we put our minds to it.
Fran Belibi is just different. She's not your normal girl dunker. Remember, she's only 6'1".
Your pick may actually take over. Beautiful dunk by Precious. But I think we will see Scotty Lewis get the crowd involved. And I think that's something where...You know, in a dunk contest, you've got to get everyone involved. This is a great dunk from Precious. And you see taking off outside of the lane, similar to what Julius Irving did, of course, in the series way back in the day versus the Lakers, except for the Doc didn't dunk it. He finger rolled it.
And you see a home run right away.
Let's see it, Scotty. Hey! Wow!That is what gets them to their feet. That should be straight tens across the board.
I'll tell you what that is a Sports Center top 10. He shoots three, Scotty Lewis, but this time he's jumping over three. Powerful.
And I can recall seeing many people jump over other players and bringing in props to jump over, but I cannot remember seeing a windmill with it happening before. And of course,Scotty Lewis, when he dunks that.
Yes, he is.
I mean, he just elevates and he keeps going up.
It takes it to a different level, Mike, because I know this is how you used to do on your Nerf hoop, jumping off the bed.
It does present a nice aerial aesthetic for photos. And I didn't even finish the dunks on the Nerf hoop either. Hardly qualified to talk about it, let alone do it.
And of course,
On the first attempt.
On the first attempt, all the excitement, everyone up, and she throws it down. And I tell you right now, there's no squeak to that dunk.
Crowd's into it. He's going to punch it.
Oh, good call, PB.
Come
on, top of that, baby.
I didn't dunk, but I could coach some dunkers.
And that dunk is impressive. Very impressive dunk. And you look at where he catches the basketball. Let's not even take into consideration the 360. But look at where he catches the basketball and brings it from to turn around the vision to be able to finish that off. That is special. And you're talking about 6'3". We're not talking 6'6", 6'7". You're talking 6'3".
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
No one dare put up a 9. That should be. Oh, we got an 11. We got an 11.
Where did the 11 come from? These scores go to 11.
Greg Oden bought in his own scorecard.
Should have brought a 20. Scotty Lewis over 2. The windmill.
And moving his head out of the way so that he doesn't hit it on the rim.
He's going to take 3 strides to get to the line. Oh! Oh my goodness! He got there in 3 long steps.
And he had room to go.
He was hang time so long.
He did not have to stretch out on that one. He had room to go. No way there's a 9 on that. Watch he this. Took off from half court.
Number one player in the senior class, right on the free throw line.
About 14 feet away.
Passing it over to let everyone know she's jumping off her right foot, dunking it left-handed. I can tell you right now, Cuzzo, all the guys here cannot do that. That is extremely difficult to do. And you see it's recognized by the judges with all 10s across the board.
And she's the only dunker with perfect 80s in both rounds.
What's so impressive, excuse me, Corey, the ability to hold the ball with one hand, palm it and dunk it. You see a lot of girls can touch the rim. They got height, they got bounce. But not many that I've ever seen can palm it and flush it.
Off, Scotty Lewis.
So when you take off from that far away and you do a windmill, you must receive all. Who's got up a 9? Oh my goodness. Whoever the judge is with the 9, put him out. You take off from right inside the free throw line and do a windmill.
Had a little Zion to him with the cock down and
absolutely
around.
Absolutely. Spectacular. Perfectly, friends. Got to finish it all. Woo, 2 hands even.
They want it. They want it off the backboard. Yes, you can, Fran! All 10s.
Fran talked about Haley's ability to throw the lob. Haley with the beautiful pass. And Fran finishing it off, 2 hands.
Corey, she's got a 31-inch vertical.
Honestly, PB, I would think it was more than that.
It the looked way like 35 on that one, but I'll tell you what.
Time is short.
Oh, yeah.
Impressive. Once again, shouldn't be anything under 10s over there. Greg Oden, where is your 11 card?
We're
off the side of the glass, 360, 2 hands. This is the same dunk that Wiseman tried to do from the other side earlier. Didn't make it cleanly.
With great athleticism, it's expected.
Between the legs after the bounce off the backboard. Yes, sir.
It's got to be an 80.
That was not expected.
It's got to be an 80. It's got to be an 80.
It's perfect.
That's got to be 90. Look at.
Where's that 11 card Theo had? Well, Greg Oden, somebody had an 11 card earlier.
It was Oden.
It needs to be bought out for this right here. Precious Achiuwa. Oh, my goodness. Like you're flying through midair. I'll tell you what was even more spectacular. She didn't start at half court. She started at the 3-point line with the crowd around her and the cape to finish it off jumping over.
And at the end court, she had the little kick out with the legs for style. But you're right, she started at the 3-point line She held that ball in one hand the whole time. Amazing.
Let's go to Noah.
I'd like to introduce Pat Belinsky, the VP of the Coca-Cola Company.
Fran, congratulations on behalf of the brand Powerade and the Coca-Cola Company. Not since 2004 with Candace Parker has there been a female winner. So I'm excited to crown you this year's champion.
Fran,